TalkMan Radio Fantasy Football Podcast.
So let's look at Carson Wentz and Jalen Hurts' value as of right now. Now, we haven't had the draft yet, but we'll talk about that too as we look at who's surrounding both of these guys. We're going to do Wentz first. Let's look at Carson Wentz. So, Carson Wentz, we're going to look at wide receivers as of right now. Well, let's start with the offensive line. So, this offensive line is ready to roll. You got Quentin Nelson there. You got Ryan Kelly there. Mark Lewinsky played pretty well. And Braden Smith and Chaz Green are two young tackles. But you're in the middle of that line. You're good to go. And I don't think you got any problem with that. Quentin Nelson's, he's like one of the best offensive line we got. So you got five guys in front of you. They're pretty good. So immediately you have an upgrade on your offensive line, which is going to help when you don't have guys running in your face all day. You got a second to, all right, survey, go. Rather than, drop back, I'm running. And you don't want to see this guy running. You want this guy back there throwing the ball, not getting hit because he's Fabergé. So, that's a knock on him. Don't pretend like it ain't. That's absolutely, you don't want this guy getting hurt. So him moving to a better offensive line immediately ups his value. And ups his value to what it was in Philadelphia. So you've got a better offensive line. I think a lot of people would say that. I think the consensus of people would say that. Your weapons, let's look at your backfield. Jonathan Taylor, Nyheim Hines, you're good. I think Jonathan Taylor's going to be, he played well this year in his rookie year. I think you're going to see a significant jump next year. He showed he can catch the ball a little bit, make some plays. I think he's going to do that. They want to run the ball there. They have that offensive line that they can run the ball behind. It protects Carson Wentz. You've got Nyheim Hines who catches the ball out of the backfield, played well last year, made the most of his opportunities, had a bunch of touchdowns. For a backup running back, he played, off the top of my head. I mean, I had him in my league. I'm going to say five touchdowns. I may be wrong, but somewhere in that area, between four and six, let's say. I know he had two in one game. But he also helped in PPR, drop back, release valve. That's huge. That's exactly what they want. On top of that, you've got, I don't know if they're bringing back Marlon Mack. I think his contract might be up, and it's, all right, see you later, buddy. And maybe they pick up another guy in the draft and in free agency to round out that backfield. But you got two guys back there with two roles to play that play them well. So your backfield is good to go. My opinion, that's what I think. I think that's what they're looking at, and that's how they want their backfield to look. Jonathan Taylor runs the ball, catches a few passes. Nyheim Hines, third down back, effective. Now let's go to wide receivers. Now, moving on from the Eagles wide receivers, pretty much anybody you go to is going to have better wide receivers outside of maybe Jacksonville. But, and New England, their wide receivers kind of crappy too. But these guys, they got real guys over there. T.Y. Hilton, he's still got that speed. He's got a lot of it. I don't know if he has all of it. He has been hurt over the last few years, so that does tend to break down your speed kind of immediately, especially when you compound injuries. You're just not as fast as you used to be. For a lot of guys, not everybody. Freaking, that guy who played for the Seahawks? Joey Galloway. Yo, that dude just run by you. I was watching something good. Check out NFL Network, top 10 fastest dudes. And they show you, like, these guys look like, that guy's gone. That guy called, and then he ran away. Like, it looks like everybody else in slow motion, that dude's just fucking running. So, Joe Galloway was one of them. Even now, well, we'll get to the Eagles in a minute. I don't want to give you any spoilers, but the Eagles made a couple moves today. They made one move at least. So you got a deep threat there who's been doing it for years, knows how to play the game, and he's a deep threat, but he's not just a deep threat. He's a real wide receiver. He's a real number one wide receiver, T.Y.L. On the other side, you got Zach Pascal, pretty good player. Not doesn't blow you away, but looks like he's playing well. Played well during the season. Had some decent catches. Made some plays. And on the other side, you got this guy, Michael Pittman Jr. Last year, when T.Y. Hilton went out, you saw, okay, give me the ball. A little 8-for-110, touchdown, caught some big passes. All right, you're good. Now we got T.Y. Hilton there, looking to get out of here, looking to maybe, he's getting up there. Maybe he's looking to retire or something like that. Or move on to another team. I mean, I don't know if they don't want to pay him. Because you're not getting $15 million anymore. You got your big contract. Now you're going to make a little less, especially with the injuries. But this guy's coming up. He's the kid coming up. So you got those two guys there. You get the legit guy, and then you got the kid coming up, and you got the Zach Pascal, who's hanging out there, knows what he's doing, plays his role. That's pretty good. And they showed last year, these guys with Philip Rivers back there, these guys can get some stuff done. You got to give them a shot. And it looks like that's the way they're going next year. The tight end department, here's where a little shaky there. You got Jack Doyle, Mo Alie-Cox. Okay, fine. The issue I have is when Carson Wentz was in Philly, and Frank Reich there, which I haven't gotten into yet. When he was there, Zach Ertz was catching 100 balls, 90 balls, a year. For those, like, 2-3 years there where he was top three tight end. Him, Gronk, Kelsey, I'm throwing my tight end. That's my number one guy. Now, is it going to be a big change for him? Okay, now my number one guy's a receiver. Now we have to change some things around. Maybe. I don't know. We'll wait and see. That's a question it's going to need to be answered. But Jack Doyle, Mo Alie-Cox, Jack Doyle used to be – Jack Doyle has played, in my opinion there's a guy I knew named Jack Doyle. He's sitting at a bar. That's why every time I see Jack Doyle, I'm like, Jack, this guy, he's out there playing football. I can't get over the dude sitting at the bar. Hey, Johnny. To going out there catching touchdowns. Yo, what's up, Johnny? I just can't see it. It's hard for me to wrap my head around that. So I never give Jack Doyle his due because I'm biased. Because that dude is at the bar all the time. Jack Doyle, that dude is nuts. Mo Alie-Cox, I saw some things out of him. He looked okay. But is he a number one guy? I don't know. I don't know. Trey Burton, he's been flying around for the last 3-4 years. He's been getting money. I think he was Zach Ertz's backup, and he played well in the Super Bowl. He's got a Super Bowl ring. But I don't think he's gonna. I don't think he's doing it. I think he's doing it. And Noah Togiu. I don't know who that dude is. So now, what are you gonna do now? You want to play the old? You want to make your own commercial next year and grab Zach Ertz, bring him over there. You want to do that, and then you can do commercials. Zach, what should I do? And then they're gonna do a funny little thing. You should go fuck yourself. go get Zach Ertz, bring him over, and solidify this offense. That's most likely not going to happen, especially taking that huge contract from the Eagles. So you're not going to get that. Not that, you know, and you're not going to get that. So what are you going to do? You're going to go draft it? You're going to go draft a tight end? Maybe. But then, you know, you got to hope the learning curve is just, and he comes out and plays really well. Because you need to play well to unseat Jack Doyle or Mo Alley Cox. Those guys aren't garbage. They're just not, you know, if they were at a Zach Ertz level, even now, if he's healthy, I would take Zach Ertz over both of these guys. But that's the thing, is he healthy? But a guy who could bring like a Dallas Goedert his rookie year, bring him in. That would be the play, in my opinion. That would help Carson Wentz out. That I think that would solidify his offense a little more. Not that it isn't solid now. It's a pretty good freaking offense. But that is the kind of thing that could really push this offense ahead. So overall, those running back in position, wide receiver position, offensive line position. The only position that the Eagles actually, I think, have an advantage on is the tight end position. Now, it just so happens the tight end position was really integral in the success that Carson Wentz had when he was with the Eagles. Now, that position is kind of lacking here, but everything else is really good. So, it's going to be interesting to see how this works out. Now, another thing about Carson Wentz going there, he gets back together with Frank Wright. Frank Wright, pretty good coach. You know, he's got, you know, he won a Super Bowl with all those guys. He wasn't the head coach. Carson Wentz wasn't the quarterback. But let's try to do it again. Why not? He's been, I think he was there from the beginning when they didn't bring in Frank Wright. Frank Wright was already there with who's that freaking Eagles coach? He got fired last week. Who knows that dude? I can't believe I've been listening to that guy for freaking years. Wow. The last Eagles coach. I can't believe it. Okay, whatever. God, there's something. I'm on crack or something. So anyway, Frank Reich. Frank Reich is, you know, he knows him. He worked with him during his best years. So I think there's something there. You got a shot with Carson Wentz in Indianapolis this year. Absolutely. And I think the only issue here is the tight end position. Is he a guy who needs to throw to bigger targets because he can't hit smaller targets? Is that Carson Wentz's deal? Has he fallen off the wagon that much from 2017 that he can't hit? He can't play with good players. It's to be seen. I doubt it. I think he'll be okay. I think they're, you know, when they need him to throw the ball, they'll throw the ball. But they want to run the ball in Indianapolis, so I don't think you're going to have too many games where he's out there throwing for 450 yards. You're going to get a couple because that's just the way it is in the NFL. Everybody throws the ball all over the place. But I don't think he's going to be one of those guys that shits the bed this year. Now, we've got three guys so far that have moved teams, three big-name quarterbacks that have moved teams. You still haven't even gotten into the draft yet where we're going to get Trevor Lawrence going to Jacksonville and whoever else going to whoever somewhere else, like the Jets. But this guy, yeah, I think all said and done, he'll be fine. He's going to have a good year. I think his value, fantasy-wise, where I think he's going to go, between rounds 8 and 10, I think. But I think he's going to be, I'm going to give him between QB 8 and 12. I think he'll be fine. I think it'll be between QB 8 and 12. Somewhere around there. I think he's going to play well. He's going to throw some picks. But I think he's going to play a lot better. He's got a lot more actual players at key positions to play with. Not Greg Ward. Nothing against Greg Ward. but he ain't T.Y. Hilton. He ain't even Michael Pittman. So that's where I'm going with the Wentz, the Wentz side of the argument. The Wentz side of the trade, which was the big side because he was the one getting traded. So that's what I think about that. And maybe we'll come back to this at the next season, see where it goes. Hey, thanks for watching this clip from TalkMan Radio Show Live. And don't forget, you can catch my full show every Friday night, 6 to 7 p.m. Eastern, streaming only on 12 Ounce Sports. Hey, thank you for listening. Don't forget to follow TalkMan Radio on Facebook and Twitter. And kill that like button and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget, everyone's team sucks but mine.